With turtles added to the game, now of course you need those turtle shells, that awesome turtle helmet, and you need a turtle farm. So here is an easy way to get those scoots. Hey guys, it's Chad. Scoots may be the cutest thing that, the cutest name at least, added to Minecraft in a long time. Well, those are the little turtle shells that the baby turtles drop when they become adults. And they're very useful. They can be crafted into items, put into potions, and who knows what in the future, because the snapshots are still coming out. So here is a simple and easy scoot farm or turtle shell farm for you guys to make yourself.
So here we are inside of Minecraft, and just after that little time lapse, you can see that this little area is working just great. What happens is turtles will come in here from, oh my gosh, apparently I've been awake for a little bit of time. But turtles will come in here through from the ocean. They will breed here, and you can also force them to breed using the seagrass right here. And then they will lay their eggs. And then after a while, the eggs will hatch. These little guys will aim for the ocean and try to swim away. But because of the flow of water, they can't actually get out and into the ocean. And so they will hang out here. And then eventually when they grow up, the moment they grow up, that's when they drop their scutes. And they will flow into this area right here. And these hoppers underneath will pick them up and deliver them into this chest right under here. Looks like so far we have 18 scoots from my little experiment here. There is a little bit of degradation or inefficiencies, I should say, with this design. One being, if these guys don't leave the sand area, they will grow up. I'm standing on top of my egg. Oh my gosh. If they don't leave, or if they come back on land for any reason, they grow up here and their scutes will just fall on the ground. But they tend to tend to hang out here for a little bit of time. And then also sometimes scutes can get caught underneath this area if they are just perfect. So it may be smart to cover up a few of these guys right here, so that they don't accidentally get next to those hoppers right there, and you can still grab that one chest right there. So those are the things that don't work, but overall, it works great. Remember that if one of these guys, if I was to break this, they get in there, they will trample and hurt these as best they can. So this little cobblestone wall right here is needed. So let's just go ahead and set the difficulty to peaceful, just to not hurt that little guy, you know. Oh, I think he died. Okay, well, let's make our own. I actually already recorded this without audio. Hilarious. Earlier. So just choose a bit of beach that is kind of long for you to make it. You can make this any size that you want. I like to keep the beach a little bit flat just for aesthetic's sake. There's no real need to. But it's kind of nice if the beach is a little bit flat. Also, remember that your wall that you build can't butt up against any blocks. Otherwise, the zombies will just walk over those blocks and on top of your wall. So you do need that area a little bit free. So once you've picked the perfect spot, you're going to take any type of solid block and build out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, just like that. Over here, we're gonna build 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then create a way across, just like this. Next, you're gonna wanna clear this out. Some beaches come out a little bit more shallow. Just make sure that there's no blocks in your way. And this is just kind of, just to make sure that the water flow will be perfect. Now you are going to fill in this area because the little babies will swim underneath this and escape. And you do not want that. Two blocks, should be fine. And then create a little floor just like this for all that. One of these may have to be broken for your chest to fit through. Now you're going to create that water flow, that perfect water flow. And the way to do it is to build this out 3 and 2 underneath. So put down just any temporary blocks. You're about ready to destroy this. You're just getting rid of the water source blocks so that that waterfall will flow. And then just break these, and you can break them really in any order. It's pretty forgiving here. You don't have to worry too much. And you can kind of see why we broke some of those other blocks, is if we had any blocks sitting out here, it might stop the water flow. Now, you are going to get a slab. Any type of slab will work. And you're going to place it on the bottom of these blocks right here, just like this. There you go. And you can see that the water flow actually kind of comes up a bit. And this will make sure that any item in this water flow area will eventually... it has some momentum on it, but if we kind of toss that, there you go. Maybe that one's just stuck on the bottom here. It will eventually make its way over to the top of these slabs, just like so. Well, underneath those, that's going to get filled in just a bit, so that shouldn't happen. But most things will land on top of the slabs, and then they'll get sucked up by some hoppers. Also, grab a chest. I have a trapped chest here. Let me just grab a normal chest. And find a place for your chest. It could be on the edge. Could be really anywhere. Let's go ahead and build it on the edge right here. That's kind of nice. So we're going to place it right there. Place a hopper right on top of that. And then place hoppers pointing into that hopper. Why am I having difficulty here? Let's place it there. No. We want it. Okay. All my hoppers are placed. Let's fix that. There we go. And so each hopper is pointing into the other so that any item that it falls on top of this will get sucked in, fall down the line, and then end up in this chest down here. Now we just need to make sure that this will be safe from other mobs. And the way to do that is to create kind of a barrier here so that any zombies trying to get at it this way will hit that block barrier. But all of our turtles will be able to go inside. And then also any type of fence will work. Or you could also build this up with a 2-block high, thing so that things can't get up it. So let's just choose any fence right there and place it down like this into this area, remembering what I said before about blocks next to the fence. And we'll just make sure this is all closed up. Now you need a light source. Any light source will work. I made it fancy earlier by using some end rods, but of course torches will work just the same. And just make sure that nothing is going to spawn on the inside of this. That would be devastation. So just light this up generously to make sure that nothing spawns inside. Now you need to get some turtles, and you can do this a few ways. Either you could swim out here, find some turtles, and get them over to follow you, just kind of like a cow or a pig or really anything. They'll follow you as long as you have sea grass in your hand and get them all the way back here. Or you could get a boat and get them in the back of a boat and get the boat over here. Or if you're in creative mode like me, just get a turtle spawn egg and just spawn in a few turtles. Once they're in this area, you can feed them seagrass and they will love each other. And then they will work their magic to put down some eggs. And they're going to put down a bunch of eggs, you know, not just one. They will put down anywhere between 1 to 4 eggs. This gal put down 2 eggs, and you can do this over and over and over again to get a whole bunch of eggs. We're going to speed this process along by using some turtle spawn eggs to get a whole bunch of babies. And there we go. Oh, and one more step. In order for these turtles to be able to leave, we need to add some slabs to the top of this, just like so. And there we go. Now the adults will be able to escape, but the babies won't be able to fit up there. Oh, what? One of the babies is getting hurt. How are you getting hurt, baby? Oh gosh, they're escaping. Oh no. Okay. Well, the pro tip, fill in that area. Fill in that area. And then also you can fill in this area. I did find some turtles would get under there and then grow up, and their scutes would get caught in there as well. So if you just block this area up, Get out of there, turtles. There we go. And you won't have that issue either. Oh, God. Ooh, just stopped him. Now, it looks like they're kind of getting in that area. You could block that as well if you don't want them to get under there. And then you can just get at your chest from the side. It looks like a few of our babies escaped. There you go. So make sure you block all that up. And then your turtles will not escape or be in an area that their scoots can't be picked up. And already, this is working just fine. If we waited a long, long, long time, we can also try to feed these guys seagrass in order to make them grow faster. But if we waited, these guys would grow up. Oh my gosh, I'm placing down so much seagrass. And then eventually, their scutes would go into that little chest.
Huge thanks to Nicholas Blockos, who's had the original video that I saw, which prompted this video. He doesn't go through the block-by-block building technique like I did, but he does go a little bit more into detail about how it works, maybe a few extra tips, so you can check out his original video in the description down below. Thanks so much for watching this episode of OMG Craft. If you enjoyed it, please give this video a like. Please subscribe to the channel for future tips, tricks, tutorials, and spotlights. And make sure you leave a comment down below letting me know your thoughts. See you next time on OMG Craft. Bye!